I'm Corey Wallace, a physician scientist who specializes in researching new treatment options for patients with immune-mediated diseases, including for a condition called Hidradenitis Suppurativa, also known as HS. HS is a chronic systemic inflammatory condition where an overactive immune system contributes to inflammation below the surface of the skin. The inflammation starts on the inside before showing up in the layers of the skin as painful bumps, nodules, abscesses, and tunnels. HS usually develops in sensitive areas where hair grows or skin rubs against skin, like in the groin, underarms, inner thighs, among other areas. HS can progress, getting worse over time, and the formation of tracts or tunnels between abscesses deep within the skin, as well as scarring on the surface and more. HS affects women 3 times more often than men, and it's more prevalent in people with skin of color. The highly visible, physically debilitating nature of the disease can take a toll on patients' mental health as well. In fact, one study found that 24% of patients with HS had at least one mental health diagnosis. So our work is not done at AbbVie. We are focused on deepening our understanding of what is driving this disease at a molecular level and finding new targets in an effort to deliver treatments that raise the standard of care for patients.
I was diagnosed with HS at 41. I've been suffering with it since I've been about 12. I went to doctor after doctor after doctor, and no one knew what it was. When it got so bad, they would cut the lesions open, which was probably making it worse, right? It was painful, it was embarrassing. There's the negative connotation of, is it a hygiene thing? Or maybe if you just change your diet, or maybe you just lose a little weight. So sometimes it can feel very isolating. Having a diagnosis now makes it a little bit easier, knowing that it's not necessarily something that I have caused. There's a treatment plan laid out for me. It doesn't necessarily mean that I don't get the outbreaks, but at least I have help. I have a dermatologist. I have not discovered anything that consistently provides relief, that consistently reduces the amount of outbreaks. There are some days where it's extreme pain, but a lot of times for me, it's more of a mental battle. I'm grateful that I got my diagnosis, and I'm grateful that people are working to uncover more about the condition. I think it deserves to be studied, and I think it deserves to have trials and eventually, hopefully, a cure developed.
I'm Tim Radstake, a physician scientist at AbbVie, and I lead the Department of Immunology Discovery Research, where scientists are looking to discover new ways to treat HS. So why is HS difficult to treat? Picture your immune system operating like a network of factories throughout your body. It produces highly specified proteins and cells that fight off harmful bacteria and help you recover from injuries like burn wounds. When your immune system is healthy, these cells and proteins usually stay at a normal level. But when they come across trouble in your body, the factories get a signal to crank up production. This sudden increase in cells and proteins causes inflammation to happen. This is a natural reaction, but for people with HS, the signal to create inflammation is uncontrolled, producing too many cells and proteins throughout the body for too long. Through research to better understand these potential mechanisms underlying HS disease, scientists continue to identify inflammatory proteins called cytokines. Those are elevated in the skin of patients with HS. AbbVie is working to investigate the targeting of these cytokines in patients with HS. Building on more than 25 years of experience in immune-mediated inflammatory diseases, AbbVie is focused today on finding new targets and developing novel mechanisms that may help more people living with HS, like Lakeisha.